5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thunderbirds are go.
Thunderbird 1, piloted by Scott Tracy, is always first on the scene when a rescue is in progress. With a top speed in excess of 15,000 miles per hour and the ability to change from vertical into horizontal flight, it has a mobile control console from which operations can be directed.
International rescue from Thunderbird 1. Changing to horizontal flight.
She's quite a feat of engineering.
Thunderbird 1 arrives on the scene. They now radio back to say we need this, that and the other. So now you have to have a transport aircraft, which was Thunderbird 2. The thing that impressed people enormously were the palm trees dropping back. I mean, in truth, they were obviously toy palm trees, and they were stuck into two broomsticks, and the operator would just get hold of the broomsticks and twist them, and the palm trees would go back.
Broomsticks? No, that can't be right. Anyway, Thunderbird 2, piloted by Virgil Tracy, is basically a freight-carrying craft. Though much slower and heavier than Thunderbird 1, Thunderbird 2 is often at the heart of the main action in the danger zone. One time, it was even mistakenly shot down by the U.S. Navy.
1, 0, fire!
More height, Virgil. You need more height. Come in, Virgil. Virgil, are you okay? Virgil, pull her up.
Virgil, you're crashing. Pull her up.
Virgil, get a grip on yourself.
You've got to pull out of that dive.
Easy does it. Easy.
The wheels, they've collapsed.
Oh. I can't hold her. I'm gonna crash.
Release foam, section B.
Luckily, there was no lasting damage, and Virgil was okay. There is one particular aspect of Thunderbird 2 that we sure are proud of. The center section carries one of a selection of 6 pods, each housing a different rescue machine.
This business of all the pods going up at Thunderbird 2 when it was getting ready for flight worked very well, because you could believe then that there were, you know, all sorts of equipment, and they were going to choose that particular equipment for this particular rescue.
Three of my favourites are the transmitter truck, the mole, and the firefly. Thunderbird 3, piloted by astronaut Alan Tracy, is really a giant space rocket. We use it for all space rescues, and it also provides us with a link to Thunderbird 5. It's the tallest vehicle in the International Rescue Fleet, measuring 200 feet in height. It launches from its concealed hangar beneath the Tracy Island roundhouse.
Thunderbird 3, well, I was never very keen on that. I mean, it was set for space rescues, and we used it a few times, but it never really excited me.
Never really excited him? You cannot be serious. How can he say that? Anyway, Thunderbird 4 is our underwater and sea surface craft, piloted by aquanaut Gordon Tracy. It's usually carried to and from the danger zone aboard pod 4, which is one of the 6 pods carried by Thunderbird 2. Although it's much smaller than the other Thunderbird's craft and has a limited range, Thunderbird 4 plays a vital role in international rescues underwater operations. It's one of the fastest known craft on or under the sea. It's a pretty nifty machine, and it saved the day on more than one occasion. Now, Thunderbird 5, usually manned by John Tracy, is International Rescue's space station and the nerve center of the organization's communications network.
Base to Thunderbird 5.
Through the use of sophisticated monitoring equipment and special filters, Thunderbird 5 is able to tune in to messages of distress in any language.
I didn't like the design of Thunderbird 5, but it came in very useful because, of course, it received the distress calls in whatever language, it didn't matter. But also it had the side benefit that I hated John as a character, and I was able to stick him up in Thunderbird 5 and leave him there for the whole series, so it came in very useful for me.